The I am, YHWH, Allah. There is no God but He, the living, the self-existing, YHWH in Hebrew, I am in English, eternal. No slumber can seize Him nor sleep. His are all things in the heavens and on earth. Who is there can intercede in His presence except as He permitteth? He knoweth what appeareth to His creatures as before or after or behind them. Nor shall they compass aught of His knowledge except as He willeth. His throne doth extend over the heavens and the earth, and He feeleth no fatigue in guarding and preserving them, for He is the Most High, the Supreme, in glory. Let there be no compulsion in religion. Truth stands out clear from error. Whoever rejects evil and believes God hath grasped the most trustworthy handhold that never breaks. And God heareth and knoweth all things. God is the protector of those who have faith. From the depths of darkness He will lead them forth into light. Of those who reject faith, the patrons are the evil ones. Cross-reference, Enoch chapter 15 verse 8. Now the giants, who have been born of spirit and of flesh, shall be called upon earth evil spirits, and on earth shall be their habitation. Evil spirits shall proceed from their flesh, because they were created from above. From the holy watchers was their beginning and primary foundation. Evil spirits, demons, shall they be upon earth, and the spirits of the wicked shall they be called. The habitation of the spirits of heaven shall be in heaven, but upon earth shall be the habitation of terrestrial spirits, who are born in earth. End of cross-reference. From light they will lead them forth into the depths of darkness. They will be companions of the fire, to dwell therein, forever. Hast thou not turned thy vision to one who disputed with Abraham about his Lord, because God had granted him power? Abraham said, My Lord is He who giveth life and death. He said, I give life and death. Said Abraham, But it is God that causeth the sun to rise from the east, can thou then cause it to rise from the west? Thus was he confounded who, in arrogance, rejected faith. Nor doth God give guidance to a people unjust. Or, take the similitude of one who passed by a hamlet, all in ruins to its roofs. He said, Oh! How shall God bring it, ever, to life, after, this, its death? But God caused him to die for 100 years, then raised him up, again. He said, How long didst thou tarry, thus? He said, Perhaps, a day or part of a day. He said, Nay, thou hast tarried thus 100 years, but look at thy food and thy drink, they show no signs of age, and look at thy donkey, and so that we may make of thee a sign unto the people, look further at the bones, how we bring them together and clothe them with flesh. Cross-reference, Ezekiel chapter 37. The hand of the I Am was upon me, and carried me out in the spirit of the I Am, and set me down in the midst of the valley which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about, and, behold, there were very many in the open valley, and, lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord, I Am, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, Prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the I Am. Thus saith the Lord I Am unto these bones, Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live, and I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the I Am. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold a shaking, and the bones came together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them. Then said he unto me, Prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, Thus saith the Lord I Am, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, Our bones are dried, and our hope is lost, we are cut off for our parts. Therefore prophesy and say unto them, Thus saith the Lord, I am, Behold, O my people, I will open your graves, and cause you to come up out of your graves, and bring you into the land of Israel. And ye shall know that I am the I am, when I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up out of your graves, and shall put my spirit in you, and ye shall live, and I shall place you in your own land, then shall ye know that I the I am have spoken it, and performed it, saith the I am. The word of the I am came again unto me, saying, Moreover, thou son of man, take thee one stick, and write upon it, for Judah, and for the children of Israel his companions, two tribes. Then take another stick, and write upon it, for Joseph, the stick of Ephraim, and for all the house of Israel, his companions, the ten lost tribes, and join them one to another into one stick, and they shall become one in thine hand. Cross-reference, Genesis chapter 49 verse 10. And when the children of thy people shall speak unto thee, saying, Wilt thou not show us what thou meanest by these? Say unto them, Thus saith the Lord I am, Behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is in the hand of Ephraim, and the ten tribes of Israel his fellows, and will put them with him, even with the stick of Judah, two tribes, and make them one stick, and they shall be one in mine hand. And the sticks whereon thou writest shall be in thine hand before their eyes. And say unto them, Thus saith the Lord I am, Behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen, where they be gone, and will gather them on every side, and bring them into their own land, and I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king to them all. And they shall be no more two nations, neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms any more at all. Cross-reference, ch. 35-10, neither shall they defile themselves any more with their idols, nor with their detestable things, nor with any of their transgressions, but I will save them out of all their dwelling places, wherein they have sinned, and will cleanse them. So shall they be my people, and I will be their God. And my well-beloved servant shall be king over them, and they all shall have one shepherd, they shall also walk in my judgments, and observe my statutes, and do them. And they shall dwell in the land that I have given unto Jacob my servant, wherein your fathers have dwelt, and they shall dwell therein, even they, and their children, and their children's children forever, and my well-beloved servant shall be their prince. Cross-reference, Daniel chapter 10 verse 21, forever. Moreover I will make a covenant of peace with them, it shall be an everlasting covenant with them, and I will place them, and multiply them, and will set my sanctuary in the midst of them for evermore. My tabernacle also shall be with them, yea, I will be their God, and they shall be my people. And the heathen shall know that I the I am do sanctify Israel, when my sanctuary shall be in the midst of them for evermore. End of cross-reference. When this was shown clearly to him, he said, I know that God hath power over all things, behold. Abraham said, My Lord, show me how thou givest life to the dead. He said, Dost thou not then believe? He said, Yea, but to satisfy my own undertaking. He said, Take four birds, tame them to return to thee, put a portion of them on every hill, and call to them, they will come to thee, flying, with speed. Then know that God is exalted in power, and in wisdom. The parable of those who spend their substance in the way of God is that of a grain of corn. It groweth 7 ears, and each ear hath 100 grains. God giveth manifold increase to whom he pleaseth. And God careth for all and he knoweth all things. Those who spend their substance in the cause of God, and follow not up their gifts with reminders of their generosity or with injury, for them their reward is with their Lord, on them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. Kind words and the covering of faults are better than charity followed by injury. God is free of all wants, and he is most forbearing. O ye who believe, Cancel not your charity by reminders of your generosity or by injury, like those who spend their substance to be seen by men, but believe neither God nor in the last day. They are in parable like a hard, barren rock, on which is a little soil. Cross-reference, Matthew chapter 13 verse 5. 13-5 Some fell upon stony places, where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness of earth. End of cross-reference. On it falls heavy rain, which leaves it just a bare stone. They will be able to do nothing with aught they have earned. And God guideth not those who reject faith. And the likeness of those who spend their substance, seeking to please God and to strengthen their souls, is as a garden, high and fertile, heavy rain falls on it but makes it yield a double increase of harvest, and if it receives not heavy rain, light moisture suffice that. Cross-reference, Matthew chapter 13 verse 8. 13-8 But other fell into good ground, and brought forth fruit, some an hundredfold, some sixtyfold, some thirtyfold. End of cross-reference. God seeth well whatever ye do. Does any of you wish that he should have a garden with date palms and vines and streams flowing underneath, and all kinds of fruit, while he is stricken with old age, and his children are not strong enough to look after themselves, that it should be caught in a whirlwind, with fire therein, and be burnt up? Thus doth God make clear to you his signs, that ye may consider. O ye who believe! Give of the good things which ye have honorably earned, and of the fruits of the earth which we have produced for you, and do not even aim at getting anything which is bad, in order that out of it ye may give away something, when ye yourselves would not receive it except with closed eyes. And know that God is free of all wants, and worthy of all praise. The evil one threatens you with poverty and bids you to conduct unseemly. God promiseth you his forgiveness and bounties. And God careth for all and he knoweth all things. He granteth wisdom to whom he pleaseth and he to whom wisdom is granted receiveth indeed a benefit overflowing, but none will grasp the message except men of understanding. Cross-reference, Daniel chapter 12 verse 10. Many shall be purified, and made white, and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall understand.